The biggest challenge for South African journalism is undoubtedly the digital transformation. The business model has been yanked right from under the feet of journalism right around the world. The old newspaper, magazine, advertising-driven model is no longer, the center's not holding. And we're needing to come up with new ways of paying for good, objective, fair, in-depth journalism. The alternative press in the 1980s and 1990s is very exciting. And in a sense, we are returning to that now because of the power of social media, because of the ability of cell phones to take marvelous video and great photographs, etc. In a sense, you've got a people's movement, this rise of the citizen journalist or the active participant is our version, our digital 2014 version of the alternative press. And I think it's having a similar kind of effect. It's bringing a spotlight to many areas where there just hasn't been a spotlight. In health journalism in particular, one has to advocate for good health. So one's got to be evidence-based, one's got to have a story to tell, and one's got to go out there and try and do no harm. That's a form of advocacy journalism. It's not giving quacks and charlatans a platform in your media, even though they may have loud and articulate voices. There have often been questions about blogging getting confused for serious, well-informed opinion. Anyone can start a blog, just as anyone can tweet. The public is a lot more sophisticated, in my view. On political issues, health issues, they usually can tell the difference between someone who's done careful research, is attempting to show the nuance, recognizes that there are different opinions, and someone is just pushing a position. So generally, I have a lot of confidence in the public's ability to distinguish between something that's produced professionally and carefully and something that's just someone's opinion. We have a lot of young journalists coming out of our journal schools that are filled with exactly the same enthusiasm for wanting to tell the full story, for wanting to get to the bottom of things, to wanting to see the media playing its role in active and vibrant democracies. So from that point of view, I'm very pleased at the 20 or 30% of the students that are coming through our ranks and graduating each year, and they go on to be fine and fantastic journalists.